All right, gonna try this today. If I'm a Runcam racer nano laying around, so try out that camera on this thing. Also got the antenna out. It was kind of tucked in there. I don't know if that'll matter much. It's not straight up, so anyways. Also change the rates to like 1.0 and 0.7, just the default Betaflight rates. Still in Betaflight 4.1. Haven't changed that yet. But anyways, we'll see how that does for today. And I'm gonna put you on the shade, so hopefully you'll probably just be looking at my back. But anyways. It's pretty windy. Flashies. A little dark in the shade, but the coloring of this is so much better than that other camera. Oh yes. It's hard to get over the top of that because the wind's blowing so hard right now. Goodness. But not too jumpy. For all the flashies and stuff, you know, this wouldn't be such a bad experience. I mean, in the wind, of course, but from a video standpoint, this camera ain't so bad. Ooh boy, that wind is sticking. See if I can get in. Not a bad camera. Looks way better than that, just the Runcam Racer Nano. I mean, not Racer. Runcam Nano. This is the Racer Nano. Just the ability to adjust them. You gotta have OSD on it. Really, any camera. You know, even the DJI cameras, ones you can't adjust, they're just no good, really, most of the time. Even the DJI camera, you can adjust it, even though you don't need to most of the time. But, on these analog cameras, you definitely want to be able to adjust them. Anyways, that's it for now. Still thinking about how and when I'm going to convert this to DJI. You know, through that camera in there, it makes it usable for a little while longer. Well, maybe play with Betaflight or something. But yeah, it's probably going to become DJI eventually. Pretty sure.